Hey everyone, I'm Stacey Friedman, the General Counsel of JPMorgan Chase. For this year's Out and Equal Summit, I've been asked to share with you some thoughts on what it means to be bold. I'm super grateful for this opportunity to talk with you for a few minutes about what I believe this means and why now it is more important than ever to be bold. Let me start by accepting this is a very complex question and there isn't one answer when you get into the details. Because when I thought about this question, what does it mean for me to be bold? All these ideas flew through my head. Bold is an openly gay woman in a position of influence at a large corporation. Bold is a mother of two teenagers. Bold is a lawyer who's passionate about the fight against injustice. Or bold is a white woman who's keenly aware of the plight of our Black colleagues. What's interesting though, is if you pull back, no matter how you ask the question, there are some basics that I believe to be true for everyone, regardless of how you approach this challenge to be bold. I believe there are some universal truths for all of us as to why it's important to be bold now and what sort of boldness is needed. So let's start with the why. Here's the universal truth on why now is an important time to be bold. More than any time in my life, our destiny is under attack. We did not seek or provoke this assault on our freedoms, but it is happening. In the United States, we see federal rules being rewritten to permit discrimination against LGBT parents who want to adopt. Healthcare policies are being rewritten to deny trans patients the care they need. Economic and societal disruption is disproportionately impacting the Black members of our community, as recent events again bring to the forefront their centuries-long fight for equality and equity. And around the world, we are seeing anti-LGBT plus forces feeling increasingly emboldened to attack us. So what boldness is needed at this time? The next universal truth can be boiled down to one word. Action. What action we each take will vary, but the measure of boldness right now is what you are going to do to rise up in this moment. It is clear that if we want to live in a society where we are truly out and equal, we are all going to have to take actions that help us and our companies live up to those two important words. We're going to have to take action to make sure everyone in our companies and communities can be out and equal. Now, maybe some of you are thinking, she's not talking to me. I'm not the type of person to be bold. Maybe this is your first time at the conference. Maybe you're new to your company. Maybe you're just starting your career. My friend, I'm talking to you. A crisis does not create character, it merely reveals it. And there is boldness in you, I'm sure of it. I'm hopeful because every single one of you watching me has already proven your ability to be bold. How do I know that? Because each of you made the decision, the bold decision, to be leaders at your organization, actively working to make sure that these are places where everyone feels they're able to be who they authentically are. It's why you're at this event like this, to learn, to grow, to meet others, actively committed to making your own company better and a safer place to work. I want you to remember the boldness that was required of you the first time you decided inclusivity was a value you were willing to stand up for. That if you're cisgender, that you needed to be bold in demanding trans equity so your trans coworker feels able to be out and equal, both at work and at home. That if you're a member of a community that's suffering disproportionately right now, how bold it was of you to share your experience with me and with others, because everyone needed to hear your voice. And let me promise you, one bold voice is enough to spark change. I've seen it work at JPMorgan Chase, which is a huge company. I've seen grassroots employee advocates who have emboldened the push for changes at our firm. I can point to individuals and small collections of groups who have rightly advocated for a firm to do more, to make sure that everyone can be out and equal. This is sponsoring Pride celebrations in locations like Warsaw, Poland, where the JPMorgan Chase Group has been recognized as a finalist by Out and Equal for the New Employee Resource Group of the Year, an Audi Award recognizing their bold work what they're doing in that country to create an inclusive workspace. It means signing on to amicus briefs to the U.S. Supreme Court to support LGBT plus workers seeking protection from discrimination under existing civil rights laws. It's rolling out same-sex partner benefits and gender reassignment surgery coverage in India, and changing our family planning benefits in the U.S. to be more inclusive for all kinds of families. It's signing a pledge in Singapore that HIV status should never be grounds for firing somebody. It's finding ways to partner with nonprofits like the Human Rights Campaign, SAGE, the LGBT Center, and others, despite the pandemic, efforts which also have been recognized by ONE as finalists for an Audi Award. And finally, at this historical moment in the Black civil rights movement, it is increasing our intersectionality in programming and conversations. All of this is the direct result of bold voices, individuals in our company, our employees. I know this ask feels like a tall order right now. We're exhausted, and it may seem like too much. I get it. Some days we have the energy to fight, other days it takes everything to take care of ourselves and our loved ones. But my friends, it's not enough. It's not enough to tell each other what's going on outside our doors is terrible and not step outside our regular lives to change it. It's not enough to just accept that your friends, family members, and coworkers support your ability to be who you are and love who you love. Because if we're waking up every day and seeing our rights stripped away, this is not about differences of opinion or political parties. It's about safety and healthcare and education. It's not a difference of opinion, it's a difference of equality, and it requires action. Your moment to be bold is here. What does it look like? Having you, our colleagues, our executives, our teachers, our parents, our young adults, our public servants, our small business owners, focus on the changes that they can make that can happen right in front of them through their own small actions. Because here is a fact about history. When networked, responsive, and empathetic people, colleagues, neighbors, and friends, rise to the challenge, there is change. That is how our community has driven incredible global successes in marriage equality. It is how we won so many battles in the ongoing fight to decriminalize homosexuality around the world. It is how we have made such important progress in the fight against HIV and AIDS. So when you shut down for tonight, take some time to identify two small things that you will do in the next week, month, year to make sure that your company and your community is a place where you feel out and equal. It doesn't have to take long. If we all collectively take steps, a few small steps, then together we will be changing what the path forward looks like. And wouldn't that be bold?